done that. Wow. Well, we started this series a month ago talking about dating. We know that you guys are interested in dating. If you're not interested now, we know that you will be. And some of you guys are already dating, and we love dating. So actually, Mike and I don't date. But we do love going on dates. And we love dating. We know it can be so fun, and especially when you do it God's way, it can be amazing. So we talked about the first week, we talked about this idea that dating is for companionship. I am made for completion. So many people get into a relationship because they think that one person is going to fix everything in their lives and make everything so awesome. They just find the one person. But only God can complete us. That's how we were designed. And so when we want to encourage you to look at dating as more of companionship, or more friendship, hanging out, instead of completeness. Only God can complete you. And in the following weeks, Zach and Jean both talked about what does it mean to be a great guy? What does it mean to be a great gal? And the idea there is that instead of looking for the one to complete you, we want you to focus on being the one. Focus on being the one. If you focus on being the kind of man of God you need to be, or girls being the woman of God you need to be, God is going to bring you the perfect partner for you. It's going to be awesome. And so today, we're finishing up our series talking about boundaries, this idea of boundaries. And boundaries are so important, not only in relationships, but real life. I remember as a kid driving with my mom and my grandma up Mount Baldy. It looks like this. It's called Mount Baldy. It's in Southern California because there's no trees on the top of the summit. It's 10,000 some odd feet up. Yes.
It's kind of like our head.
That is so correct. It's Mount Us. That's absolutely correct. And so we took the drive up to Mount Baldy is filled with roads like this, where it's like sometimes there's a guardrail, a lot of times there's not. There's very no shoulder, or hardly any shoulder, very no shoulder. I talk really well. And then sometimes there's a car width over there, but on the other edge, it's just down the hill. And so this one time we stopped to take a picture, and we parked on a side just like that, except there was a little more room for a car. We got outside, took a picture, and I remember being so spooked about it. I'm like, Mom, take a picture of our car. And she took a picture of it right there where it was parked. So we get in. I'm in the back seat. My grandma and my mom are right there. And my mom puts it into gear, and instead of driving forward, she drives backwards.
Mm.
And you can feel the right rear wheel go off the road.
Way.
And so, of course, I soiled my pants at that point. Not really, but I was totally scared. My mom, she's so amazing. She responded like any brave woman would, and she fainted. She was down for the count, and I only knew that because my grandma came over and slapped her. She's like, psh.
Hey.
Yeah, she's like, you need to get us out of here. So put on your big girl panties and get us out of here. Good night. I will never forget that. So I can't imagine. If that's like Mount Baldy, I can't imagine Donner's Pass, you know, a place that looks like this, where it looks beautiful, but oh my gosh, so scary.
Donner's Pass, I mean, it's beautiful, look at it. The scenery, wintertime, summertime. I'm a truck driver, I was in manufacturing, said repetitive work, wanted to get out of it, it was boring. And truck driving just led me to all kinds of freedom to go out and see the country. So I was a rookie from, long story short, from Ohio to Nevada, it's kind of flat, windy, windy roads, metro areas, more rural than anything, a lot of cornfields. I'm a rookie. I'm with a trainer.
This is when you're just beginning driving.
Just beginning driving, learning the ropes, learning the rules, safety rules.
Driven through these easy states, like flat land, and then you get to this place in Nevada.
And we stop and have lunch right before this place. And he gives me an explanation of, you know, how heavy are we? How much freight's in the box? The engine brake, is your engine brake working okay? Engine brake is designed to slow the truck down without using your brakes or burning your brakes. Your brakes can get very hot and catch on fire. That's another safety rule. There's a process of driving in the mountains. So we're having lunch. He tells me all this. Now, Donner Pass is 7,400 feet elevation. And we live in Ohio. We've experienced a couple days ago 60 degrees, right? 2 days, 2 days later, it's 28 degrees.
Right.
So you experience all four seasons in about 9 miles. Just like kind of what you see, it was sunny. He said he was putting chains on his tires and shorts, so he left warm weather to get to the cold weather.
Crazy, and it gets cold and dangerous. I found these pictures online of all those semis all crashed together. Good night. And so, the snow gets up high.
I mean, you're talking 6 to 8. Look at the description of the snow. I mean, and that's on the road.
I can't imagine trying to drive one.
It's tough. So when you're up, and what the rules are, once you're up on the hill, we go to the safety inspection station. We pull in, we check our trucks, make sure we do all our preventive maintenance. If it's icy, if it's cold that day, put chains on our tires, because we're getting ready to descend down the mountain. And descending down the mountain, like you guys seen with Ken and his explanation with his mom and Mount Baldy, there was no guardrail around that turn. So I explained to you engine brakes. If my engine brake's not working properly, I'm going downhill with 80,000 pounds. That's a lot of weight pushing. So I gotta know what I'm doing, follow the rules, follow the safety rules, know everything going on to get that truck around the corner and all kinds, whether it's dry pavement, wet, ice. Because what happens if we go over the cliff?
Yeah, you're done.
You're done, you could die.
You're going to share with us some of that later on.
Yes.
It reminds me of just the guardrails that God puts in our lives.
And, yeah, to kind of flip that around, I mean, that's why, you know, that's why we have rules. That's why there's rules and boundaries that are set up in our lives. You hear this, sometimes rules are made to be broken. Not true.
Oh, yeah, and our lives are filled with boundaries and rules and guardrails. So we want you in your small group to jump in and talk about what is a life rule or boundary that you think is really important. What's all right? Well, we want you guys to learn to remember two things today, but especially this one, and that is that boundaries are blessings. Boundaries are blessings. You know, architects and engineers were designing Donner's Pass, it's not like they were trying to figure out what's the worst way we could build this road. Like, how can we make this road like the most difficult, worst journey ever? No, they were like, how can we make this the quickest, safest way for people to get from point A to point B? And I think just like that, I think when God created us, he gave us some boundaries, not with the mindset of trying to hold back our fun, but with the mindset of, man, I want to create for you guys, I want you guys to have the richest life, the best life ever. And so I have these guardrails, these boundaries for you, that if you'll stay within these boundaries, you're going to have the best life ever. Absolutely. Boundaries are blessings.
Boundaries are blessings. Maybe we can go off a little bit from Donner's Pass, explain it a different way. How many like Christmas? I know it's hard to do. I mean, you guys love Christmas, right? And the gifts, and who's excited about the gifts under the tree?
Oh, yeah,
okay.
We all are.
And who wants to know what they are when mom and dad's not around? I know some of you, including me right here, when I was you guys' age, used to shake that gift a little bit, hear the rattle, right? And if you got caught, they said, you know, don't do that, it could be fragile, you could break it, blah, blah, blah. So anyway, where God set the boundaries with the gift, you see those gifts, the surprise is when we wake up Christmas morning, you get to open it, and it's an awesome surprise. That's one way of looking at it. And the boundary is, you know, and the rule is we're going to wait till Christmas. The next way to look at it, if we're shaking that box, put it down, we tear it a little bit, ribbon it a little bit more, hide it from mom and dad, we see what it is. Now we wake up at Christmas. We're not surprised so much anymore. It's not as exciting. We kind of crossed that boundary, broke that rule, and we're more worried about, because now we're not going to show the enthusiasm to mom and dad or Santa Claus or whatever, how excited we are. So,
I've had that happen before, where I remember I was 8 or 9 years old, and my mom got me a present, and I did that same exact thing. I ripped it, and I thought it was fine, and I put it away, and I came back the next day, ripped it a little bit more, and then I had to pretend that I was surprised at Christmas Day. I was worried my mom was going to find it and be disappointed in me. Yeah, absolutely. But, you know, God's Word has some specific things about about this idea of boundaries, right?
Right. There's actually, and there's a verse in 1 Corinthians 6, 18 through 20. And I'll read it for you. It says, "Run from sexual sin. No other sin so clearly affects the body as this one does. For sexual immorality is a sin against your own body. Don't you realize that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit, who lives in you and was given to you by God? You do not belong to yourself, for God bought you with a high price." We know what that high price is, right?
It's the Lord.
But he died for our sins. So you must honor God with your body. So we don't even own our bodies. I mean, we more or less run them. I mean, from what that verse tells me, you know, don't you realize your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit? So, we're renting this. This is temporary.
Yeah, this idea of sexual immorality, I mean, no one talks like that. But the idea is that if sexual immorality is having sex or sexual relations with someone that's not your spouse. So if it's not your spouse, then that's not appropriate. In other words, that's the boundary God has set for us.
Right, and if you guys, I mean, with Zach's message and then Gene's message last week, you guys are priceless. I mean, you really are. You're a lot better. Remember the example with the iPhone? How many remembers the hammer?
Oh, yeah.
Oh boy, I have not forgot that hammer yet. I sit right over here in my small group and that hammer hit it.
Yeah, that's the last time I let Gene borrow my phone.
Right. And don't let her have a hammer.
Yeah.
But no, I mean, for real, you guys are priceless. You're more important than a phone. And some of the, you know, in the phone, there's temptations there too with texting, the internet. With the internet, that everything that we can do on a phone, I'm sure you guys all are aware of. But we are more important than that. And
So it's this whole idea of you must honor God with your body. So what does that mean? You know, this idea of God has created these boundaries. How do we honor God with our body? So we want you to jump in your small groups and wrestle that question. We're talking about boundaries or blessings. What does it mean to honor God with our bodies? We'll give you 5 minutes for that, and we'll run back up here to wrap things up.
Sounds good.
All right. Honoring God with our bodies. That's so huge, so huge. This whole idea that boundaries are blessings. It's huge, you know? And so the question is, you create these boundaries, these guardrails in your lives. But what do you do when the temptation just seems so overwhelming? You have that guardrail in place, but you're coming close to it. You're doing things that you know are not appropriate, that you wouldn't have planned to do. How do you resist that temptation, that desire to do it? We want you to remember this. Flee, don't flirt. Flee, don't flirt. Just get out of there. I love this passage in Proverbs. It talks about this. Can a man scoop fire into his lap without his clothes being burned? Can a man walk on hot coals without his feet being scorched? So is he who sleeps with another man's wife. No one who touches her will go unpunished. Just like what you said, Mike, every guy that these girls date is someone else's husband, most likely. And for you guys, every girl you date is going to be someone else's wife. And so to set up those boundaries, and you know, I think a lot of times, that whole idea of scooping fire in your lap and then hoping you're not going to get burned. We do that a lot with sometimes the websites we go to, the videos we watch, the text messages we send, the pictures we send. And it's easy to think, hey, this isn't hurting anybody. No one even knows about this. But man, you are playing with fire. And that stuff really does affect your relationships. I see it all the time where marriages are broken because of a mom or a dad that decides to cheat on their spouse, or a mom or a dad they're looking at pornography and they think that's not going to affect their life, and that stuff wrecks it, and it begins now. I remember it began with me as a middle schooler looking at pornography, and it affected my life too. Boundaries are blessings, and we have got to flee from temptation. Flee, don't flirt.
Absolutely. I mean, it's just like Ken said, flee, don't flirt. You gotta run from sexual immorality. I mean, it's scary. There's rules set in place, guardrails, boundaries. You remember last week when Gene had the cell phone? Who was here last week to remember Gene had the cell phone up here?
Yeah,
had the
hammer, letting her borrow my cell phone.
Yeah, no. That's an expensive one. So again, with pornography, you know, with the phones and the messages, that's why she busted that phone. And, you know, the temptations that are there that are on the phones, TV, you know, just different things that are going on. It goes back to Corinthians.
Yeah.
We belong to the Holy Spirit. Our bodies belong to the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And, you know, if we... There's boundaries and rules that he set up in that verse. If you read that verse, it'd be just like when I told you about Donner's Pass. It's nice and sunny. We're going up the hill. We go to the inspection building, and there's rules. And I told you about what happens if you go down the hill the wrong way without following the rules, the safety rules, and the way to go, because there's roads without guardrails. And we go over that. What happens? 9 times out of 10, most people die. Well, you're not going to die in your relationship, but you're not going to feel good either. Because up in Donner's Pass, what I didn't tell you, there's a hallway. It's called, most churchgoers call it the Hall of Shame. And the Hall of Shame, and there's been a few survivors, but most not. I mean, the percentage isn't good in the Hall of Shame. You can see different pictures of different trucks, cars that got tangled up with trucks, and accidents because people weren't paying attention. Texting and driving, looking at the scenery, or made an honest mistake in the weather. So,
or not paying attention to the rules, and some of those drivers didn't follow those boundaries.
He didn't downshift before the curve going down the hill. There's no guardrail again.
And they lost their life.
They lost it. So, and if you bring that back to relationships, and I gave you the description about coming up to the line, you don't want to flirt with that line. You want to stay well within your boundaries, you know, of dating.
Because a lot of people will set up that line. They'll say, you know, I'm going to save myself for marriage. I'm gonna not have sex till I'm married. But then they're like, but I can do everything else except that. And they get up to that. And it's just like what you said about, if I was supposed to run a race, a 10-yard sprint, and stop at the end, if I'm going right, there's no way. I'm going to fall over there. The same way in being physical in a relationship. It's huge.
It's very huge. I mean, you guys are priceless. It's just, you know, it's what Jean hit the phone. This is a dumb phone that she hit with a hammer, and she, you know, she smashed the phone. But you guys are priceless. God loves you. God loves you all. And it's the reason why he says what he says in Corinthians, and about how you don't own your bodies, and there's rules in place, there's boundaries. You're junior high kids. You can go from, there's a time for everything. And right now, that's not the time for certain things.
Yeah, absolutely. So that's why boundaries are blessings. And so we want to encourage you guys this morning to really, we want you to pray and to ask God, where should my boundary be? And that's even a good conversation to have with your folks. And I'm sure you're like, that's the last conversation I want to have with my parents. But a good one to say, Mom and Dad, what do you think? What is appropriate? Is hand-holding okay? Is kissing okay? What should my boundary be? And then I would have a friend, your best friend, and I would say you guys commit to that. Say, hey, you know, this is the boundary I'm setting, and when I'm dating someone, I want you to ask me and to say, hey, how are you doing on your boundaries? And that way you have some accountability.
Yeah, somebody to keep you in check.
Yeah, absolutely.
Somebody to help you out.
And the awesome thing, too, is today you can decide, you know what, today I'm setting a boundary that I'm never going to do whatever it is, whatever that boundary is, and that you can, on your wedding night, tell your husband or wife, you know, hey, on March 5th, 2017, I decided to set a boundary for you, that I wanted to give you this gift. It reminds me of Christmas, right?
Mm-hmm.
To say, hey, I was not going to open up this gift until our wedding
time.
And I wanted to give this to you. I've been doing it since March 5th, 2017, so... Huge, huge issue. We hope you guys are talking with your folks about it. Believe it or not, your parents sometimes can be reluctant to talk to you as much as you are to talk about them, but it's a really important conversation to have. So come on, Cindy Hill, ladies and gentlemen. Cindy. Cindy, what were some of those boundaries? Those are great.
All right, I'm just sitting here thinking, and with our group, you guys had such great ideas, but we didn't have time to get into it. I'm thinking as you leave, you need some concrete things that you can really use. And as a mom, I tell my kids this, and I don't think they really think there's a reason behind it. But I know your mom will probably say, you're not allowed to have people over when they're not home. Because everybody's had moms that say that, I'm sure.
Yeah, that's a huge boundary to keep, to say I'm not going to do that.
Right. So the reason why is when mom is there or dad is there, you already have that excuse. Well, my parents are here. There's, you know, nothing's going to happen. But if your friend or boyfriend or girlfriend or just a friend is going to come over and you say, you know, I'm not really supposed to have you here, you don't even have to blame yourself. You can say, well, my mom and dad will kill me if I have you over. So
and you can
it's
even
easy.
You can even make it juicier and be like, my mom and dad are the worst.
Yeah.
They don't trust
we
me.
We are big people and we don't mind being meanies.
Yeah, we love being the bad guys.
Really, honestly, you are not. If you need to look, just look to us. Well, we're the ones who can take
an
it.
Easy conversation sometimes.
No, absolutely, absolutely. Well, let's pray and we will see you guys next week. God, thank you for today. Thank you for the boundaries you've given us. I know a lot of times, Lord, we think that we know better than you, and we think that your boundaries are limiting. But you, just like the creator of the architects and designers and engineers who created Donner Pass, you created these boundaries so that we can have the best life ever, the fullest life ever. God, help us to trust you in that and to honor you with our bodies. Help us to flee, don't flirt, and to remember that these boundaries are blessings. We love you, Jesus. We pray all these things in your name. Amen. We'll see you guys next week.